you know, you can feel so unbelievably lost and horrible and like you're nothing and you're invisible and for no reason at all.
You can pretend you don't miss me. You can pretend you don't care. All you wanna do is kiss me. Oh, what a shame I'm not there. You can pretend you don't miss me. You can pretend you don't care. All you wanna do is kiss me. Oh, what a shame I'm not there.
Yo, yo, oi compas and nakis, se fucked out me the mill.
Potatoes, ranch dressings, barbecue seasoning, tomato, sweet chili, white wine vinegar.
Yo, good morning. I feel like I have not uploaded a video in 3 months. I think it's even getting up to 4 months, but I haven't uploaded a video in a while. And I'm so, so sorry about that. I had a good reason, a good legit reason before I went to Nigeria. My camera broke after I came back from the Toronto trip I went on with the girls. And then it didn't come back until I was going to Nigeria in June. It came out like last week. It came back to me last week of May. And then I came back from Nigeria and you know, June, July, I was just missing home, feeling very confused and going back home since that was the first time going back home 8 years. A bit older in my 20s and done with school, I'm working now. The next thing is like marriage talk. So it was just a whole, I made a decision for myself where I said no to someone and I was just like, I felt bad. Even though I was when I said no, I felt bad because I know how excited everyone was, my parents, the siblings, and I said no. So yeah, I had to deal with the fact that I said no. So I've really not been feeling my best. And then fast forward, ending of July, double in a new project, which I'm very excited for because it's like getting me to where I want to get to career wise or it's leading me, like it's taking me to in the right direction. Yeah, so I've been trying to learn. The training was typically supposed to be get to CEO. The training was supposed to be 6 months. I got training for 4.5 days because you had to go home, like, and imagine it came up on the last day. But Yeah, so that's just it. I've been trying to live life, do more stuff, not stay at home. Try with find out we got a car, your girl got her driver's license. Vroom vroom, screw screw. Yeah, I got my driver's license, we got a car. So today is Sunday, it's a cloudy day. I want to start bringing out videos, but I just really wanted to talk to you all. We're gonna sit down later on and just have a heart-to-heart conversation. I did a few things yesterday, which was Saturday. I think I took little clips here and there, so I'm gonna put it for you guys to see and enjoy and watch. This is the most updated video I'm making, so I'm gonna try and make it come out on Wednesday, so I'll explain how my videos are gonna roll out for you guys so that you guys are not a bit confused. And just to apologize, I just did not feel it was okay just bringing out videos without apologizing to you. Some of you even sent me message on Instagram. If you're not following me on Instagram, you'll follow me on Instagram. I'm there. But some of you sent me message on Instagram asking where are your videos, because I've been showing stuff. I am back. I feel like I am just killing my potential. You know when you're just like killing? I'm killing myself. I'm killing my potential. I'm not doing what makes me happy, which is I love to vlog. I love to edit. I love to edit. And also, oh my gosh, I think I have something. You all, my music. Okay, so I've been trying to just, you know, I like the music I put on my vlogs, right? This hair needs to go. I love the music I put on my vlogs, but I've been trying to really spice it up and use more of Nigerian songs. I went back to Nigeria and I remember that I am a Nigeria girl, and I fell in love with, like, I've always been in love with Nigerian culture, don't get me wrong, but I fell deeper in love with it again. Because mind you, I've not been in Nigeria for 8 years, so I went back and I was just like, wow, this is my country. I'm not even going to be waiting that long again to be going back home. And now I just want to, like, take the music of my vlog in a different direction. I want to use more Afro beats, and I finally figured it out, and that's why I'm even very excited to start recording, because I have figured it out, thank God. But yeah, today's video is mainly going to be about a reset. I'm going to show you guys my mess, because this is me trying to get my life together, planning out for the week, because it's Sunday. I haven't been saying my devotional consistently in the morning. I need to really reconnect with myself and the things I love. Start going back to the gym. I'm going to start vlogging for you guys at the gym. I don't even care if people are there. Yeah, so I'm going to start going back to the gym. I registered for a gym outside of my apartment, which is nice, because then I get to see people since I'm still working from home. But with the new projects I have, I'm going to start going into the office once in a while. So you guys should get ready for office look or office whatever it is. But anyways, get ready for a work outfit. That's about it. We're going to have a better chat along the line or along the way. But I have a few things. I'm going to be babysitting today. I am super excited. This is going to be like my first time babysitting her. I cannot wait. I literally cannot wait. I want to make Nkwobi today for dinner. I haven't made Nkwobi before, but like I said, I went back to Nigeria and I'm just eating Nigerian food. Yeah, so I'm going to make Nkwobi. If you're Igbo, you know, cow leg. I'm going to go around, run some errands, and take you guys along with me. I need to do some work stuff. I have to do a training for something I need to do on Monday. I have a video I want to watch, so I'm going to log into my work laptop and watch them. And yeah, so let me just show you guys what we need to do. That's the energy. Okay guys, let me show you guys around. Okay, definitely did need to do laundry for sure. Well, I was just using to clean my face, so yeah. Actually, if I go ahead and do what I need to do, I'm gonna put my eye mask and leave this on for a while. Under eye. Oh, I want to pierce my ear. I went to Nigeria and I pierced only one. And I was so scared because the way they did it was so different from the way they do it here. It was not sanitary. The girl just took the piercing, and it was why I braided my hair, and she just poked it in. Which now that I see that I don't have any injuries, I wish I did like one here and maybe two here again. Like an extra one there and two there. But I was too scared because when she did the first one and it was not sanitary, it was just poking, no wiping. I think she only used, after she was done, she used, what was this thing? It's not crown. Oh my gosh, that molded big stuff for hair. Oh Jesus, I can't remember. I remember Shasha, she just used it to rub it around my ear, and I was like, girl, don't touch my ear again, don't pierce anymore. She was like, yeah, don't pierce. If I'm going to be injured, let it just be one. But now that I'm seeing that I healed properly, I'm just like, girl, you played yourself. Yeah, next time if I go to Nigeria, I'm not going to be doing smear. I'm a typical Nigerian, nothing to kill African man. She remembered that. But yeah, I'm going to at some point go get this one pierced and maybe one here. No, that's doing too much. My father would disown me. Okay, I'll get one pierced here, and then the typical, the star I had before, but I'm not trying to pay $160 for the piercing again, but we'll do that. Okay, I have my eye patch on now. I'm gonna keep this on for a while. See what I mean? It keeps on sliding. I'm so pissed. That's why I don't like using this thing most of the time. Just, I know you're drizzly and drippy and juicy. Just stick to my face. Okay, let me show you guys the mess that we are working with. I just showed you my washroom. So let's go to my closet and room. This is my closet, by the way, which I'm sure some of you remember. This thing keeps sliding down. Please don't slide down, please. Okay, so I need to fold. I have a cloth here. I need to fold the clothes everywhere. I need to definitely take care of this. Have clothes here, and then this is the room. I have my jeans. I was trying out some jeans that I've had, like my baggy jeans, and I need to fold them back. I got some new workout outfit. I tried to do like a trial. I need to fold them. I did laundry like last week and I never got to the point of folding them. And then I need to vacuum my room. Hi guys, I need to vacuum my room, water my plants. We're gonna go ahead and make coffee first, actually, and then we'll do our devotional.
She doesn't want to cook. You want to cook. But yeah, we got a few stuff from FG. Yeah, we got I put a roll and meat pies and pounded yam. Okay, here's the first one, guys. 2 pounded yam, one for me, one for Sissy.
Sissy's our sugar mommy.
Oh, how much did the meat pie end up being for? This is the 2 meat pie. How much was everything?
17.
But yeah, 2 meat pie, one for me, one for Sissy. The meat pie itself is already opening. And then there's one more here. I think I'll take this one. It doesn't look like it's open. Let's see. Of course, there's no meat.
There's no what?
The meat is inside, inside.
Yeah.
This is the pepper. Hey guys, good morning. It's a new day and this vlog that was supposed to be one day is really spreading out. Like, it's literally spreading out. But either way, I'm going to wrap up the vlog today.
I saw you.
Say my name, say my name. Okay guys, I found it. I'm just gonna quickly screw it in. Yeah. So we can have a chat and I can end this vlog, y'all. I think I'm gonna cook later today. Maybe I'll just put the cooking video as well. Okay guys, so where have I been? First of all, I just wanted to start off saying sorry for that inconsistency this year. I have been so inconsistent. I just want to first of all say I'm sorry. I've just been so anxious, so scared. I've been so lost. I've been so confused. And it's just like, I feel like there are so many things. If you ask yourself what was even doing, I can't even explain it. I just know that sometimes, like the last couple of weeks, I wake up just not feeling my best, not feeling myself, just feeling sad, and I didn't want to really do anything other than just work and do my best at work. The work is kind of the most important thing I have right now, and that might sound sad, but I mean, of course, my family is important to me, but outside of my family, and I was just like, I need to give my best and all to that, even if I feel like I'm slacking on every other thing, I cannot slack on work in particular. I think recently I've just been going through the pressure of being in a relationship and having someone, because the girl is getting older. I don't want to be single in this world, and it was just like kind of like a pressure on me, and I was just so sad about it. Like, it's like I forgot how to live and enjoy being single. I was just emotionally drained, so scared that I didn't have the content, the quality, whatever you guys wanted. I don't know, I was scared. It was mainly just based on allowing my fear to keep me from doing what I liked, especially when it came to YouTube and just uploading content for you guys. My fear was really like played a big role in it. And it was just when I was talking, my sister was always like, are you vlogging, are you vlogging? And I'm like, no, I'm not vlogging. And people are texting me, when are you bringing out your next YouTube video? I just wasn't mentally there. Sometimes I'll wake up and I would not even want anybody to talk to me. I just want to be on my own. You know when you just want to lock yourself up and just want to be on your own and you don't want to have any contact with anybody? That's how I feel. I think another thing that really stressed me, there was someone back home that was, this guy was literally ready to marry me, and I was just like, nope. And it hurt me more than I thought it would when I said no. And I had to also learn to like deal with that particular thing. I think that was even the root of everything, because I was like, I'm saying no. What if this is supposed to be my person and I'm saying no to the person, right? And what if I'm going to remain single because I said no to the person that was supposed to be my person? But I was like, I had to come to terms with, I'm okay if that's my person and I end up not marrying the person. I end up being single, God forbid. But I just had to come to terms with that. And that's how I started getting back to myself. I started feeling a bit better. So, yeah. But in that way, I've just been scared about everything, about life, except for work. Because, of course, your girl likes to make money. So, got to work. But I'm so sorry about that. That's not an excuse. And I just really wanted to apologize about that. And moving forward, I really just want to upload consistently, get into my routine, get into my groove. I had a routine before, I know I can get into it. I started going back to the gym and stuff like that. So yeah, I think I'm getting used to being single again. It's not like I was ever in a relationship, or I'm remembering how to be single again, or how to enjoy being single and just loving on myself and taking care of myself. And yeah, I think that's about it. But with that being said, this is the way the vlogs are going to come out. The vlogs are going to roll out in this particular way. I do not just want to start uploading without explaining what's happening, and I apologize, and truly, truly apologize. I hope my apology is accepted. I'm going to do better. I'm going to be better, and I'm going to give it my all. I've traveled twice this year, so I'm going to start with the first trip, which is my Toronto vlog that I had with the girls, which was so fun and so exciting. That was when we celebrated Opet's birthday. It was really nice. And then I think I did not vlog because my camera broke. I think I mentioned this earlier on. So after that particular vlog would be the Nigerian vlog, which I don't know why I vlogged, y'all. I don't know why I vlogged. I don't know if you guys are gonna like it. I don't know what happened. That will be the next vlog, and we'll go from there, and then we'll just go back to the normal routine of uploading weekly vlogs. That's about it. I'm going to end this vlog here. Expect all the travel vlogs to start rolling out. I don't know if I want to bring out the pack with me for Toronto. If you guys want to see that vlog, let me know. I'll bring that one out first before bringing out the Toronto travel vlog, and then the Nigerian travel vlog. Let me know what you think. Nigeria was fun. It was amazing. I love Nigeria. Oh my gosh, I love Nigeria. I love my country. I love Nigeria. I love my culture. I love everything. But yes, guys, I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye. Bye, guys.